So we're going to start with the panel discussion for the Career Growth Summit 2021. So we have with us three panelists. Our first panelist is Milind Sulakhil, a chartered accountant with 23 years of experience working as financial lead for many Indian and multinational organizations, currently working with CTDI India, a US-based multinational as CFO, taking care of finance, HR, and SCM. Next on our panel, we have Mr. Dinesh Sumpal, Director, Software Department, Urjanet, an engineer from NIT Bhopal and MS from BITS Pilani. He has 2 decades of experience in IT software industry. He has experience in working across geographies. As a part of Wipro, he has worked in US, Canada, and many Fortune 500 and with many Fortune 500 clients for the last 10 years. He is currently handling software development team in Urjanet, and that is connecting businesses to data from thousands of utilities across the world. The next panelist, and the third and the final panelist that we have today, is Mr. Narasimha Rao. He's the lead IDC operations in Nike. Mr. Rao has 18 years of experience from across the industry from consulting, auditing, and operation. He possesses an exceptional background advising on critical IT strategies, building high-performance teams, and delivering measurable results in both high growth and downturn business cycles. He has a proven competency in suggesting appropriate as well as technology-based solutions for enhancing functional efficiency of the organization and achieving business excellence. He has an extensive experience in project estimation, evaluation, liaison with clients and project team, and full life cycle implementation of various ERPs. I, Shruti Thakkar, will be the moderator for today's panel discussion. A warm welcome to all our panelists. I'm sure our attendees are as excited as I am. So let's kickstart today's panel discussion with our first question. So warm welcome before I begin with the first question. I hope you're all set for the discussion. So here goes the first question. For this question, we're going to reach out the same question to all three of our panelists. The question is, what does growth mean to you? Let's start with you, Mr. Milind.
This is the best place. I mean, why we are having this summit, right? So this is a growth. I am already in the advanced stages of career and already at a CFO position. So now, and with the recent discussions which I had with JJ on various aspects of life, my latest objective of growth, which I am keeping as my growth target, is having more time for me, right? So that's the that is having the richest person is the one who has more time with him. Right. So that's what I am looking for. That's what I will be looking forward as my growth objective from here on. Of course, and this growth, other aspect of this is just for the short term. But as the overall aspect, growth is basically in all aspects of life and not only just one piece. Now, what happens is generally we just concentrate on one aspect of life, which is career. But as in one of my sessions with JJ during this inner circle, which we had. It was a big realization for me that I have been over focused and over conscious about my own job and career and over focused there than handling the all other aspects of life. So you gain some, you lose some, right? So you have to balance it out somewhere. And that was the JJ's critical advice that that growth, but simultaneously all around growth and not just in one aspect and destabilizing the other aspects. So that is most, the holistic growth is growth than just having just one piece as a growth. So that's where, thanks to JJ actually, because that realization, it took me really long time because of this over focus on this job. Somebody has to stand in front of you and tell you, boss, wait, this is, you have to change your gear and then you will be more realistic. So that's the growth for me, the two aspects which I talked about.
I think thank you so much for sharing it. I think that's the most appropriate way of saying it. Our gears are in the fifth speed ever since we start school, and it doesn't slow down until somebody actually puts on a pedal on the brake for you and says, "What is your life about? What is good to you? Look at it holistically." That's very well, sir. Thank you so much, sir. We'd love to hear your thoughts, also, Mr. Narasimha.
Yep. So the way I consider growth is we are the best creation of this universe, right? So what we set ourselves is to be that best, right? So what I am today, I need to be improved version tomorrow. That's what I keep looking at. It's not just career like Milind mentioned. It's the overall personality of you. How do you behave yourself? How do you behave with your family, closed ones, your colleagues, how you do as a professional? So it's all what you are today and what you will be tomorrow, right? So what improvement you keep adding, that's the growth. End of the day, it's the peace of mind, right? I have done better than what I was, right? So that is the growth for me.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing that. I think that's absolutely I think the point being well-rounded, all-rounded growth in all areas of life is what is the key point to look at it for life growth in general and even for career growth. Mr. Dinesh, we could hear your thoughts also on what is growth according to you.
Sure. For me as well, I feel that growth so far, what we have been really working for is money, being able to grow in the life, in the career, in the company is growth that we had been kind of thinking through. But of late, what I see is that it's not just the career growth that is required. You need to be having it as a personal as well as a career growth. So you should be having your work. When we say work-life balance, it's a work and life. It is part of your life. So work cannot be a separate entity, but we consider the whole work to be a separate entity and try to only excel in that. So in that respect, we really need to have a holistic view and try to grow ourselves in the manner wherein we feel satisfied. We cannot keep running. It's not a running race wherein we would want to reach somewhere and then feel happy about it. It's a journey. You need to enjoy the journey. That's what the growth should be. And you feel happy at the end of the day. It's not towards after 5 years or 20 years that you will be feeling happy about. So it's more about living your daily life and feeling happy about it. And more now when I'm coming to the later part of my career, it is what I would want to be able to give to the people, not what I would want to get. So that's what is growth, wherein I can make sure that it's not just me who grows. Can I give to the company so that the company grows, the society grows, and everybody around me grows? So it's more a well-rounded growth for everyone is what I look forward to as a growth right now.
Thank you so much. I think it's a fabulous point that, you know, it's not about growth, as in it's not always about charging forward and going and chasing a goal. It's also about building yourself up. I think anyone who answered the question of where they see themselves in 2020, in 2015, 5 years from now, where do you see yourself? In 2020, 2016, anybody answer that question, they're going to get it wrong because no one could have predicted COVID. But everyone who's taken advantage of those last 5 years and worked on themselves, I can guarantee they have now achieved a lot of stability in their mental space, their mindset, which helped them achieve deal with the difficulties that 2020 or even 2021 continues to provide.
Yes.
Right. So the next question is for you, Mr. Milind. How did you navigate your journey to the role of CFO?
Basically, there is nothing called as a fixed formula for this, which will work for everyone, right? There was somewhere an objective in life to become a chartered accountant. Once I became a chartered accountant, there was no scope for doing a practice because I didn't like it much. So then I joined an organization. And then the most core principles which you have in your life, those carry you in the long term. So basically integrity. And so this is not just the integrity in case basically that which comes with the CFO kind of a role, right? Where you are responsible for purchases, admin, and so on and so forth, a lot of things. But it is integrity towards your purpose, integrity towards your organization, integrity in what you do on daily basis, integrity in developing your team. So all those aspects will have to come together to get this. Because once you are a chartered accountant, if you are into that field, your technical expertise is there, right? Now, CA as a course doesn't guide you in a lot of software aspects of the job. So that's where I think I have been working on throughout my career. Of course, there is still a lot of area to work on. Still, there is a lot of way forward to move on to. But and for that, I mean, this was a realization some time back. That's where I joined JJ's inner circle, where a lot of realization keeps happening, because sometimes you get so much sucked up into your daily life and your job that you cannot find answers to everything. But you have to have your quest for excellence. Continuous learning should be there, and you have to be good at your job, right? Make things easy for you and your colleagues and subordinates. You have to be always solution oriented. And whatever has happened in the past, you should not cry and just try to improvise on the things. So these are various aspects which I have worked on and I have been working on. And that's where I got noticed, and somewhere people felt that, yes, this guy is good enough to handle the roles. So this happened from my first job itself. Within 5 years, I was the finance head for my, although the company was very small, right? So I kept on moving to the jobs. But what happens is, in the bigger organizations, going on the higher positions, it becomes more and more difficult, because you are handling only a small part of an area. But if you are a finance head for a smaller organization, you handle all the aspects, and your probability of becoming a CFO becomes easier. But then at what brand range? That is 200 crore company, 500 crore company, 1000 crore company, 10,000 crore company. It depends on your journey, the way you go. And one of the biggest advice which Jim Rohn gives, which I would like to quote here, it is for everybody. I mean, I love that advice. That is the biggest thing, that you should work more on yourself than what you do on your job. And that is the advice which he gives. And it is phenomenal. I mean, I have never had such a beautiful advice in my life. You should work more on yourself than what you do on your job. And if we do that even by 1% of whatever we are doing today, it helps you to grow as an overall person. And that's how you will be easily noticed, and you will become whatever you want to be. So CFO is just one piece. But in any area which you are working in, you will be excellent. Just you have to work on yourself, and every day. That is what will be I will tell you about my journey.
Thank you so much. I think there are so many valid points that you made. One is, I feel, a solution seeking approach. I think that is a very important factor, because that way you can constantly looking for a way to make things better. The second one, essentially, which I personally also relate to a lot, is continually working on yourself. And when you are of that thought process, you're not looking at, this is my job and this is all I would do. You extend yourself to learn how your job fits into the larger scheme of things vis-a-vis the company, and you understand your role better so you can perform better. Again, there is one third fact which you said, which was fabulous, which was, everybody can be a boss, but not everybody can be a leader. But to be a leader, you also need to know yourself better, you need to know the role better, and you need to create an environment for your team to thrive so they can deliver great results for you. Because once you grow in life, you become mid-management, senior management, you are only as good as your team. Am I right?
Yes, absolutely.
Perfect. Thank you so much. So the next question I have for you is Mr. Narasimha. What is the need to be focused on career growth in 2021?
The focus, according to me, is obviously everyone would be looking up to the technical capabilities. Apart from technical capabilities, the important factor we always keep aside is self-development, soft skills, which are very critical in this period, which makes you stand out. We might have heard Darshat in the afternoon, procrastination, what he was going through, but after he realized and he worked upon himself, that whole thing took him to this different stage, right? You heard Milin, it's what we work on, self-development. Yeah, what are that apart from technical skills, which are matters to our individual career? It can be a communication, it can be a presentation, it can be just a networking, or with an open mind going and talking to the colleagues and finding solutions to their problems. Yeah, you be open-minded and approach whatever comes on your way, so that you would be successful in whatever you do.
Thank you so much. I think that definitely makes sense. You have to be ready in your skill sets, in what you need to be good at, to be able to take advantage of the opportunities that come your way. If you get a fabulous interview, but you haven't built on your interview skill sets and you can't crack the interview, you got the opportunity, but you lost it. So I think that's a very, very valid point. Thank you so much for sharing it. The next one I have is for Mr. Dinesh. This one is for you. When you observe some of the successful leaders around you, what are some of the key growth elements you see in them?
Sure. It's a very wonderful question that you've asked right now. It's a what we have been traditionally been looking for is a very hard skill that we really need to work on. And I think most of my friends have also spoken about, it's not about just one key hard skill that you need to do. You need to have a lot of softer skills that is required. And one of that is humility. So I have three things that I really find that is there in one of those, almost all the key leaders that I've seen. Humility. You really need to be servant leader. Leadership is all about people, and you very rightly had said that it is more about you are what your team is. You are made of that. It's not an individual person. We probably have seen about Ratan Tata. He, when there was a problem that had happened, there was a terrorist attack had happened in the Taj Hotel. We know him that he was all there with his team, making sure that all his staff was safe. He also went on to give additional, the people were not working, but he went on to give them the salaries to make sure that they really do not feel disheartened for what has happened, which was none of their cause. So you really need to feel, you need to have a lot of emotional intelligence, and that's where the people will look up to you. So that's one of the number one thing that I have seen in almost all big leaders that are there. Second thing which I feel is the feeling of being able to take risks. So this is something which is, risk comes to everybody, and without risk, life is going to be a monotonous line and we really not be able to enjoy the whole life itself. So we really should not be discouraged by not being able to take risks. The only people, those who do not seek failure, are the ones, those who really do not do any work. And I don't think anybody of us would want to be that. The leaders, you can see all the leaders that have come up with all these invention that were there, they were all during tough times, and they were not fearing whether there is going to be a risk of failure or not. The iPod that was developed was just at the time when there was a downturn that was happening, and they did not know, the Apple did not know whether they are really going to be able to make it big from a computer industry into a music iPod industry per se. And they really created a whole niche market for themselves. And there's about Steve Jobs is all token about is that his risk-taking capability, and he creates a new market of himself. So you really need to be able to be the getting the first mover advantage. For that, you really need to start taking risks. Otherwise, you really will not be able to succeed. Third thing that I find, and I think it is closely related to what Rashtrath had said also, is that you need to be an action-first person. You really cannot be planning and not doing anything. And Ratan Tata also said that I am not good at planning, but I go ahead and start doing the task and make sure that I improvise so that I do a good job on it. So I think we really need to be sure as to we really start taking action. Without that, there is hardly anything that is really going to be possible. And for that, one of the key elements which is required is that we should be able to communicate what we really are looking for the people to take action, and being able to communicate in a very terse form so that the people understand what is to be done is really what the team starts working on. And I know my boss was there in my during when I was a project manager. He said that if you cannot communicate the problem to the business person about the technical challenge you are facing, you really have not communicated enough. You can probably communicate it to your architect, you can communicate it to your senior developer, but if you cannot communicate the problem to the business person in the simplistic form, I don't think you have been able to communicate well. So you really need to be able to communicate to the level wherein everybody in the company understands. And that's what we see from all the senior leaders that are there out there. So these are some three key tenets that I've seen are there in all the leaders that are there in the world right now.
I think that is fabulous. I think all the four points that you made were very relevant. And I think they're pertinent across the board. I think it's something that you can start developing when you're even younger, a junior entry-level manager or even mid-level or senior level, empathy, either with your team or people around you, being conscious of what they are going through and supporting them is the biggest way of building solidarity and support in yourself and your team. Even risk-taking, I think a ship is perfectly safe in a dockyard, but it's not built or meant for a dockyard. It's meant to take that risk, venture out into the ocean and be hit with waves and see if it survives it. So I think that's something that absolutely needs to be done. So risk taking is definitely there. I think action is, I think, the most key thing. You can make the most perfect plan, but it is of no use if you don't put it into action, because you will never know where was the mistake that you made or where was the part where you needed correction. I think that's all the points that have been fabulously shared. And last one that you said, shared, I think everyone's been going through some training around that today, communication. My theory is if you cannot communicate in 5 to 10 words or less, you really don't know or have clarity on the problem. And every other sentence you're saying is going to confuse people more than give them clarity. So first step back, get clarity in yourself, and then share. So thank you so much for these wonderful points. The next question I have is for Mr. Milind. What's your take in today's volatile environment? What's your take on career growth in today's volatile environment?
Yeah. One of the biggest advice which I would like, this is my personal analysis, that guys, demand has not gone anywhere. Okay, people are the same, their demands are the same. It is just the question of time, for which it is suppressed for some time. Okay, if you get time during this time, just build on your skills, right? Whatever aspect of your life you just want to build on, just keep building on it. And be more visible, be more visible on digital media, learn more and more things, build your personal brand. I mean, what all are the aspects which JJ has explained? And this is what it is required. That's it. Just don't get stressed out with what you are seeing today, what data. Media is generally talking negative, right? And they will keep doing that. My personal feeling, and I am very sure about it, that demand is there. I mean, you can just see the moment the things get opened, everything became really normal, right? So it is, again, we are entering into the second phase. Again, this will go and things will be normal. So don't get stressed out, right? Have a faith in yourself. Build some, of course, financial backing. You should have some backup you should build just to sustain this period if you get any setback. But then work on all these aspects if you get some time. Spend at least an hour or two every day on yourself. Keep learning some things. And that will definitely help you to come out of this as soon as the things open up.
Thank you so much for sharing that. I think that is a very wise thing that you've said. We've all gone through a lockdown kind of a phase last year. Last year was very new. We didn't know what a lockdown was or what we can anticipate. So it really put a lot of fear in us. But today, a year later, we know what a lockdown is. We've gone through the experience. And if you are still feeling the same sentiment that you did last year, then one thing is missing: growth. Personal growth hasn't happened. If you are experiencing any other emotions, you could say that, okay, I'm going to take a pause. I'm going to stabilize my career or do any element, like Mr. Milind said, you are taking that one step forward towards your career growth. So thank you so much for sharing that point. My next question is for Mr. Narasimha. Can a person grow if she or he has not planned his or her career?
Obviously, why not? Example, I am a commerce graduate, did my MBA in finance, then ended up in technology field, okay, which was never expected. But I stayed on. I saw that there is a learning opportunity. So I took it as a learning and started my career in the technology area, which helped me to grow my career. It's always what you look up to, right? You don't think that what you plan is always right. The universe always has some other plan. Okay, so be open-minded. Like I keep mentioning, you will get to know a lot of things which you don't know till now. Yeah, so yes, unplanned career will be a positive, and it has happened with me specifically.
Thank Thank you so much for sharing it. I think every time we plan, like, life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. I think that's so pertinent. We all had a lot of plans for 2020. We planned to do a million things even in 2021, and none of them happened. But can you make unplanned transitions? Of course. I think very well said, sir. Thank you so much. I think just because something didn't go to plan, don't worry. There is always another way to pivot and take on a new journey. Just be open to opportunities. I think that's the key. My next question is for Mr. Dinesh. What would be your message to aspiring young graduates taking up the journey of their career?
It's a very apt question from all the new generation that is really coming out of the college right now. I think one thing that I would say is, right out when you're starting the career, you always feel that there is a whole life in front of you, and I will probably plan it out later. So I think one thing which really you should have in mind is, see what you would want to be about 20 years down the line. So have a long-term vision about yourself, and then try to see whether you are going to be able to make some intermediary plans or not. This is the time wherein you would probably want to enjoy, but it is best that you really carve out your life so that you can enjoy all throughout the life rather than just only at the start of your career. Because probably now you have full of energy, you would be able to enjoy, but I think you need to plan your whole life. Life is in your own hands. So making goals and working towards that is going to make sure that you achieve them in a very easy and successful manner. Other thing that I feel is that you really need to be able to start at doing things and fail early, fail safe, and fail forward. Because unless and until you really fail, you really do not get to learn. Because you only fail when you are really learning new things. So learning new things is going to give you a failure. And probably from failure, you will come to know what you really don't need to do. And the earlier in life you learn that what failures should not be done, you will be really much more wiser when you come up in the later part of your life. And I know for sure that most of us really try to be thinking that, no, this is not the time, probably I'll try it later. But I think try taking up new things at the earlier part of the life. Third thing I feel is that you have entered into an era which is an industrial revolution 4.0, wherein the whole way of working, the whole way of life is going to be changing for us. So you really need to be making sure that you are ready to be a learner all your life. And I think JJ covered it as part of his session as well. You really need to be knowing what is required, which is required for industry, what is going to be coming up, and keep learning. Because the way we were doing the things about 10 years back is not the way that we are doing it now. And the way at which the whole things are changing, probably the things are going to change in another 3 to 5 years. But we really cannot deny that. We really need to accept. So the change is the only constant. Just accept it, keep learning and moving forward. And that's how you really will be able to be successful in life. Thank you.
I think that's a beautiful point. I think we generally want to postpone failure so that we feel that we are more protected, we are more secure in the present. And I think I can share this a little small anecdotal personal experience that I wasn't great at studies. So I did get a lot of shouting, a lot of no's for what I wanted as a child because I wasn't good at studying. But when I graduated from my MBA and I took on a sales role, every no that I heard, it didn't bother me. I was immune to the no. I just had a trick to turn that no to yes. And early in life, failure actually helped me be a much better salesperson and be somebody that's, you know, people sought after. So I think that's something that's absolutely fabulous. Do not postpone failure. Experience as much failure as you can in earlier part of your life. Believe me, it makes you stronger, resilient, and teaches you a lot very fast. So I think that's absolutely valid. And yes, just experience, go out there. I think Sir shared everything beautifully. Not much for me to add there. There are a couple of questions we have from the attendees and the audience. Let's pick them up for our panelists. Jogesh, would you be able to share them?
Yeah, so any questions that's from the audience that you want to ask any of these three panelists, please raise your hand, we'll unmute you, and you can direct your questions to any one of them. We've got like 5 minutes, so we'll take one or two questions. So 164
119 Manoj, we've got two of them already.
Yeah.
Krupa, alive to Manoj.
164.
Yeah, hi. Hello. Yeah, good evening, everyone. This is Pandora Tor, and my question is like, am I audible to you, everyone?
Yes,
absolutely.
Okay, so my question is like, how to know, just create your environment. Like, if you're working on something, you have no reason, you wanted to achieve something. So how could you know, make your environment every day, you know, so that you can know, every day you need to know, do little by little, one by one step you need to take towards your goals. Like you have planned, no long term plan. So I just wanted to know how to create that environment so that you could be, you know, little bit more focused.
This question,
who have you directed this question to? Like, which panelists would you want to answer this?
Yeah, means like these three of, like, they are very whosoever.
I'll probably take the question.
Please,
Mr. Ganesh. So, I think you probably would have heard Dashrath speaking about how he kind of overcame that. He joined JJ's club, and what he did is that he found a like-minded set of people who were ready to reach the goal. So first establish what your goal that you really want to do. If in case you have clarity, if you don't have clarity, probably try to join a group which is going to be able to help you do a planning. Once you have joined that, you really need to be making sure you write down your daily goals and follow them religiously and working that through, and making sure if you're getting stuck somewhere, you have that circle, mastermind circle, who's going to be able to give you a nudge. And I think Dashrath had shared his part wherein JJ was very kind enough to give him the nudge so that he could make sure he comes back onto the track. So making sure you have the right set of people around you. If you're going to be talking to the people, those who are really not going to be able to give you a nudge, probably you will really not be able to reach the place where you want to be. So find out what you want to do, find the right circle, and then making sure that you establish your goals and track them through daily.
Superb. I think, yeah, well answered, Dinesh.
Thank you so much. Yes. Yeah. We had one more question, I think.
Manoj. Manoj.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
My question is related to the same last question. If everything is going right, you will be a successful. But if something goes wrong, how to get the bounce back and to get the achievement? Because as we planned, it is not necessary to be successful, and we are working according to our plan. So sometimes it's go down. Sometimes it's reduce your confidence. Sometimes it will, things is not moving in a right direction. So how to get the bounce back and to be have a towards our the successful life?
Could we have Mr. Rao look at this question?
Sure. So, Manoj, to answer that, yes, definitely as a person, we would get into negative thoughts, right? But it may not last forever. Yeah? Every thought has certain duration of time. There are ups and downs. So whenever that down is turn is there, that is the time when you need to give a push on positivity, right? So you can look upon what is the positive aspect of that failure. You definitely would have learned a lot of experience from it, right? So take on that and how to build on further. Yeah, like you joined the club, like Dinesh just now mentioned, you joined a group of people where like-minded people are there and try to give you their part of learning and then work upon it.
Thank you so much, Mr. Rao, for sharing that. And then we have one, I think, last question from 135 meter. Can we?
Yeah, sure.
We will go ahead, please. Maybe Mr. Milan, you can take this question.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm in the IT industry. I have around 15 years of experience, actually. So my question is, how do you keep yourself motivated when you're in, especially in the mid-level career, especially in the IT industry, which has been volatile right from the beginning? With every 5 years, you would see changes, actually. And it is always the middle management that gets the heat, even from the people who are, junior to them and people who are senior to them, actually. So how you keep yourself motivated, how you try and remain an asset, how you do a collaborative work, or how do you mix kind of a thing wherein you do the work and you also get the work done actually. So any tips on that, or any pointers to that direction, so that people like me don't have to end up motivating themselves every day when they wake up and go to the office. I hope you got the crux.
Yeah, I think Dinesh would be the best person.
I know. Yes. Dinesh has to answer this.
Yeah, I think one thing which we really need to find is find the area of work that you love. I think you really need to find a reason to be able to get up and go. If you are really not able to find that reason, probably you need to either change your job or you really need to change yourself. One of the two things have to happen. So find, how do you find a reason to go? That is one thing, because that's what is going to give you a jump out of your bed and then you really would want to go.
Yeah.
How do you do that? I think there are many techniques that are there. Make sure that as you are doing this, have a self-belief and do not feel that what is the company going to give it to me. It should be more about what am I going to be able to give to the company. The more you start growing higher up in the company, what really is going to give you more returns is what the company can gain from me. The moment you start thinking about it, the more value the company derives from you, the more is your growth going to be. I think just change your mindset from what is in it for me to what is in it for the company, and you will start to see the whole growth happening for you. Because without that, I think if you really find that there is a, if your manager finds that you are bringing in a value to the company, there is no reason for you to be really feeling that you're really going to be having a trouble about it.
Just to add on to Dinesh, Viral, this is the plus side of it, right? The life cycle of industry has undergone a tremendous change, and it will keep going. The industry is going to turn around every 20 years as of now. In next 20, 25 years, it will be reduced to 10 to 15 years. So how fast you keep up to the industry expectation, that is what is important. And IT being the forefront, probably that is the first heat we will feel that. But if we look, we will be shaping up the industry. Yeah. So that's the plus side of what I look up to that situation.
One point I would add here, that don't fear, because finally good people are required, right, at any point of time. So even if you don't, you are new to that industry or new to that part of a job, but still, I mean, the parallel skills are always required. So then that people skills, the communication skills, etc. So you just move parallelly. You are handling X software, now you will handle Y. So don't worry so much. I mean, it's all settles down there. If the more the fear you have, the more the problem you will have.
Yeah, I think the soft skills are what is going to make sure. Any hard skills will keep changing. The soft skills of being able to manage is what is going to take you more forward, as Milind rightly said.
Thank you so much. I think, well, good question. You got all of our three panelists to interact with this one. So thank you so much. I'm not sure if we have time for more questions, JJ.
Yeah, no, I think we're good with the questions. Thank you so much. I think, yeah.
Thank you so much to all our panelists for taking our time this Saturday afternoon and spending it with us and sharing all these wonderful pointers. I think it's time that all of the attendees give a big applause to all our panelists for joining us, for sharing their insights and helping all of us learn together. Thank you so much for joining. It was truly an insightful session.
Thank you, Shruti. Thank you, Jogesh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Give a big round of applause for all the panelists and also to Shruti for moderating it so beautifully. Thank you so much, Shruti, for doing it so well. Thank you so much.